This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create the awesome look of hyperdrive in deep space. Before we begin, if you're not already a subscriber to my channel, click that small subscribe button at the lower right corner to let you know as soon as I upload new Photoshop tutorials. Create a new document by pressing Ctrl or Command N, or by going to File and New. Make its width 1920 pixels, its height 1080 pixels, and its resolution 150 pixels per inch. The color mode is RGB and 8 bits per channel. Click the box and pick black. We'll convert the black background into a smart object, so if we want to, we can adjust the filters that we'll be adding to it at any time. Click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel and click Convert to Smart Object. Go to Filter, Noise, and Add Noise. Make the amount 100%, Uniform, and Monochromatic. Go back to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it 0.5 pixels. Open Levels by pressing Ctrl or Command L. In the Input Shadow field, type in 143, and in the Input Highlight field, type in 150. Go back to Filter, Blur, and this time click Radial Blur. Make the amount 15, Zoom, and Best. We'll brighten our image by clicking the Adjustment Layer icon and clicking Levels. In the Input Shadow field, type in 8, and in the Input Highlight field, type in 48. Next, we'll exaggerate its perspective. Make Layer 0 active and go to Filter and Lens Correction. Click the Custom tab and drag the Remove Distortion slider to plus 100. Repeat the last filter by pressing Alt-Control-F on Windows or Option-Command-F on a Mac. Click the Custom tab again and drag the Remove Distortion to plus 100. Click the Adjustment Layer icon and click Hue Saturation. Check Colorize. For the hue, type in 200. And for the saturation, type in 100. Make Layer 0 active. To save space in the Layers panel, let's collapse the effects by clicking the small arrow. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. Change the Empty Layers Blend Mode to Color Dodge. Open the Brush Tool and Brush Picker. Pick a soft, round brush. Make its size 200 pixels, the hardness 0%, the opacity 10%, and the flow 100%. Click the foreground color to open the color picker. In the hexadecimal field, type in 227AFF. Then click OK or press Enter or Return. Place your cursor outside your document approximately here and press and hold Shift as you drag across your mouse or pen. Holding Shift kept your cursor perfectly horizontal. If you want to redo the line, press Ctrl or Command Z to undo your last step. Release your cursor and place it approximately here. Brush another line across your document. Convert this layer into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively. go to Filter, Distort, and Polar Coordinates. Tick Rectangular to Polar and click OK. Go back to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it 100 pixels. We'll convert our visible image into a smart object by making the top adjustment layer active, scrolling to the bottom, and shift-clicking the bottom layer to make all the layers active. Then, convert all the layers into one smart object. Make a copy of it by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Hide the copy and make the bottom layer active. If you're using version CS6 or CC, go to Filter, Blur, and Iris Blur. If you're using CC 2014 or later, go to Filter, Blur Gallery, and Iris Blur. I did an in-depth tutorial of the Iris Blur, so if you'd like to watch it, its link is in my video's description below. If you don't see the Iris Blur shape outline, press Ctrl or Command H. Go just above the top middle dot. These dots are called ellipse handles. When you see a curved double arrow, drag it up a bit past the top of your image. Drag one of the side ellipse handles out as well, a bit past the document. You'll notice there are four inside blue dots. These are called feather handles. Between these handles and the ellipse handles is where the blur starts and ends. Dragging one of the feather handles drags all of them at the same time. Drag it to approximately here. Blur it 10 pixels. And in the effects panel, make the light bokeh 50 and the light range 0 and 255. Then click OK at the top. Make the copy visible and active. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it 36 pixels. We'll brighten it by clicking the adjustment layer icon and clicking Levels. We want the adjustment layer to affect only the blur layer below it. To do this, we need to clip it or restrict it to the blurred layer. Click the Clipping Mask icon or press Alt-Ctrl-G on Windows or Option-Command-G on a Mac. You can also go to Layer and create Clipping Mask. In the Input Highlight field, type in 22. Go to Filter, Render, and Clouds. Make the Levels 1 copy active and click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask next to the active layer. Open your elliptical marquee tool and go to a corner. Drag your cursor to the opposite corner and release. Go to Select, Modify, and Feather. Feather it 200 pixels. We want to fill the inside of the selection with black, which essentially fills that area of the layer mask with black. Before we do, check your foreground and background colors. If they're white and black respectively like mine are, press Ctrl or Command plus Delete to fill the selection with black. However, if the colors are inverted, press Alt or Option plus Delete. Your layer mask should have a soft black elliptical shape inside it. The black area is essentially masking out the middle of the blurred copy, while the white area is revealing its outer edges. Deselect it by pressing Ctrl or Command D. Next, we'll brighten our entire image. Make the top adjustment layer active. Click the adjustment layer icon and click Levels again. Since we want to brighten our entire image, this time we won't clip it. In the Input Highlight field, type in 190. Lastly, we'll enlarge our image to crop off any bloomed out areas we don't want. To do this, scroll to the bottom of the Layers panel and shift-click the bottom layer to make all the layers active. Open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. If you see this message, just click OK. If you're using a version earlier than CC 2019, go to a corner, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it out until you no longer see the bloomed edges. If you're using CC 2019 or later, just press Alt or Option as you drag it. Then press Enter or Return. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.